Historically, mini bulbs have been used in many applications such as puck lights, decorative fixtures, and landscape lighting. They have been either halogen or xenon, and more recently, now come in LED versions as well. Replacing these bulbs, however, can pose many problems. In many instances, there is simply not enough information printed directly on the bulb to identify the base type, voltage, or wattage easily. Well, today, we'll show you how to identify your mini bulbs easily and accurately. The first step is to determine the base type. In most cases, you will have a mini bipin bulb, which has two straight pins coming out of the base. To identify the type of bipin base you have, you will need to measure the spacing between the pins. You can use a ruler for the measurement, but a digital caliper is best as it gives you a more exact measurement. If the pin spacing measures a quarter of an inch, you have a G6.35 base. And if the spacing is less than a quarter inch, you have a G4 base. Now, if the spacing is more than a quarter inch, it is a G8 base. G9 bulbs, on the other hand, will have either flat or looped pins. If the pins are partially encased, then you have a wedge base bulb. Some mini bulbs actually won't have a standard pin base. If the bulb has two small knobs on the side of the base and installs by twisting and locking into the socket, then you have a bayonet bulb. Single contact bayonet bulbs have one contact point on the very bottom of the bulb, while double contact bayonets have two. Bulbs with points on each end of the lamp are called festoon bulbs and can only be used in festoon sockets. Bulbs with a screw base can be one of three sizes. A screw base measuring 11 millimeters is mini candelabra, or E11. 12 millimeters is a candelabra, or E12. And 17 millimeters is an intermediate, or E17 base. The second step is to determine the voltage and wattage. Now, voltage can run anywhere between 6 volts to 120 volts, and can be either alternating current, AC, or direct current, DC. Wattages will also vary. If this information isn't printed on the old bulb, then you will need to check the fixture. Most fixtures will have a label or a stamp that notates the maximum wattage and voltage. Once you have confirmed the wattage and voltage, you can start looking for a replacement bulb. Be sure that the new bulb's wattage is equal to or lower than what the fixture requires to avoid overloading it. If you opt to upgrade to an LED bulb, make sure to check the dimensions. Most LED mini bulbs tend to run larger than their halogen and xenon counterparts. If you are unable to confirm the voltage or wattage of your fixture, we strongly recommend speaking with one of our 1000Bulbs product experts at 855-948-5079. They can help you find exactly what you need and help answer any questions you may have.